This news update is brought to you by
You Can Forget. But remember the Rumble. 30 men. One match.
'Cause we gon' blow your mind.
Winner headlines WrestleMania. Remember the Rumble, live from the Alamo Dome.
It's Tuesday, January the 17th, and this is your Barbados Today Evening Update. So glad you could join us. I'm Emmanuel Joseph. There is no way that the Barbados dollar will be devalued, declares Minister of Finance Chris Sinclair. In fact, he vows to resign before any such move. Sinclair made the bold declaration today at the height of growing concern about the state of the Barbados economy on the back of a grim report from the central bank and the recent downgrade by Carrie Chris.
There's not going to be any devaluation of the Barbados dollar on this administration. If the next one wants to do it, they will do it when they become the government, if they become the government. I am going to say that. I can tell you right now, I would resign as Minister of Finance. There's no devaluation of no Barbados dollar.
The Finance Minister made the statement while speaking in Parliament during debate on the Bank's Tax on Assets Bill 2017. Sinclair assured Barbadians that he will soon speak on the state of the economy. He stressed there was no need to engage in what he called politics of panic.
What is the purpose for panic in an economy that is growing? What is the purpose for panic in an economy that unemployment is going down? What is the purpose for panic in an economy in which we have adequate resources to defend our currency, reserves to defend our currency? They may not be at the highest possible level. We said our strategy, and I will explain all of this, what our strategy has been. We've lost investment grade. We don't like that. I mean, throwing that all around, repeating it all the time to depress Barbadians. I mean, you know, if that suits some people's purpose, well, then that is for them. But we've said that, and we've said that we will win our way on what we earn in foreign exchange, and that we are not going to be running to the capital markets, borrowing at exorbitant interest rates, as has been the case in previous administrations.
Debate in Parliament was heated today. Prior to St. Clair's contribution, opposition leader Mia Mottley chided the government for tabling the holidays with pay bill 2017 while ignoring troubling issues facing the country. Mottley told the House it was unfair for debate to take place at a time when Barbadians were more concerned about job security. But House Speaker Michael Carrington would have none of it, and he reprimanded Mottley, who stood her ground, insisting that Barbadians wanted answers. Carrington, however, ordered the opposition leader to take her seat, and Mottley subsequently left the chamber with some of her parliamentary colleagues. At a news conference shortly afterwards, Mottley told reporters she has no intention of playing around with the people's business.
The Barbados Labour Party is clear that it cannot be business as usual in this country. We put legitimate questions that are not ours, but questions for the people of this country. Mm-hmm. We will remain focused on these issues. Mm-hmm. And as for George Pilgrim, just tell him we are ready. Thank you. Yes.
Opposition MPs who flanked their leader expressed concern that Parliament was becoming irrelevant. St. James Central MP Kerry Simmons says this government is not treating the business of the people seriously and they won't be part of it.
It is clear that the institution of Parliament is being toyed with by the government. And we don't want to play a role of assisting, aiding and abetting that. So you may find that more of that which we do increasingly takes place out of Parliament.
A leading Barbadian diplomat has passed away. Former Consul General of Barbados, Earl Glasgow, died this morning at the age of 85 after a brief illness. Glasgow was posted in New York in the ambassador's role from 1986 to 1994. He was awarded the Order of the British Empire for his excellent service. His son, Andrew Glasgow, told Barbados Today his dad was ailing since December 7th, and the family has been preparing for this sad moment. He said his father was a great provider and would be sorely missed. In today's sport in action, Greenhouse Giants are the new track and field champions of Lawrence T. Gay Primary School. The Green Champs ousted last year's winners Red House by 56 points at the National Stadium this morning. Keshawn Burnett and Adrian Maynard took the Victor Ludorum honors in the under-9 and under-13 divisions with 48 points respectively, while Tanika Griffith totaled 55 points to take the Victrix spot. Greenhouse amassed 386 points. Runners-up Red Rockets had 330 points. Third place went to the Blue with 212, and Yellow came in fourth with 186 points. Here's action in the boys under 13, 200 meters.
There's regional and international news after this short break.
Get your paper, get your paper. Only 225, 220. Who? For what? That's the best still news. I done read about that from Barbados Today since last night. That can only care do. 220, who?
The Barbados Today, news you can trust.
To the region now. Case of microcephaly after a mother became infected with the mosquito-borne Zika virus during her pregnancy. Health Minister Nicholas Steele told reporters today that the child was born in the last quarter of 2016. Microcephaly is a birth defect where a baby's head is smaller than expected when compared to babies of the same sex and age. Minister Steele says the Zika infection has stabilized in Grenada and there are no new cases of the disease. He said at the height of the Zika outbreak, 11 people were diagnosed with the Guillain-Barré syndrome, GBS, a disorder in which the body's immune system attacks part of the nervous system. And on the world scene, a deadly mistake in Nigeria. An Air Force jet has mistakenly bombed a camp for displaced people near Ran in the northeast, killing up to 100 people and injuring dozens more. And workers are among the dead, with the Red Cross saying 6 of its employees were killed. One agency said it was treating 120 injured people and appealing for help with medical evacuations. President Muhammadu Buhari, whose army is fighting Boko Haram militants, expressed dismay and urged calm. The attack took place near the border with Cameroon, where the military is engaged in what it calls its final push against Boko Haram. And that's news and sports. But for the very latest, visit our website at www.barbadostoday.bb. You can also subscribe to our e-paper email updates and like us on Facebook. We are also on Izumi Media in bus terminals, or screenplay at supermarkets and gas stations near you, as well as Channel 99 on Flow TV and Mix 96.9 FM. I'm Emmanuel Joseph. Have a fantastic evening.